Hey there, as you may know, the Apple event happened 2 or 3 days ago and the iOS 14 was released for iPhones and iPadOS was released as well. Here are five of its best features and why you should get it, why I think you should get it anyway.
So at number one, we have widgets. It's not that much of a big deal, especially if you're coming from an Android perspective, because we're used to this. Like, I still have my Android because, like, I don't know, Apple tried to make things difficult. So yeah, you could have the one. So for calendar, you could have your widgets. You could come to this usual tab, or as you can see, it's changed. This already gives you some suggestions of what you normally use, and then it just goes into it. This one is for battery. For my, it tells you your battery is like me. I turn off my battery percentage, and then you know, yeah, the other widgets are here. You could easily put them in here. Now you can see all the different ones you could have, weather and the rest, the different kinds of it. So I'm not done with that because I already have it here. Now this is how it used to be on the iOS 13.
So this is what it looks like on the iOS 13. It's just a list of your widgets on like a whole widget page. You can't actually pull them out. When you click it, you kind of get straight into the app. You don't get to see the whole thing. You can't move it out. And then when you edit and you add to home screen, it just goes back to the widget tab. It's kind of basic, really. It's static. It's not the coolest. Trust me, it's only going to get better. Please stay till the end of this video.
No, that's kind of helpful. That's kind of better instead of going to having to go over here just to look at your stuff. You could easily move it around.
Yes, I agree. All these features have been on the Android since, but it kind of makes everything better to have like best of both worlds. Kind of makes it a little less seamless when you're switching from Android to iOS. So the app list makes it better. It's not just a static home screen like it used to be over here, where you just have everything in one place and you would, you know, you can just delete it straight from here. But on the iOS 14 right now, you can actually have apps only on your app list and not on your home screen, which is really cool. So you could like clear the whole thing out. That's why it's kind of better. It's kind of seamless. It's kind of, you know, I say kind of too much, don't I? But anyway, yeah, that's the home screen is a really big feature of the iOS 14. This one is kind of my personal favorite. Like, you could actually watch videos and talk to people. That is like relieving in so many ways. That way you don't have to leave people on read. You keep watching what you want to watch. I'm using the YouTube site to go to my channel and click one of my videos to show you how that works, because it's not really optimized for the YouTube app. Well, it works on Netflix, which is actually still quite cool. So this is how it goes. Once you leave the app, it still stays on your screen. You can move it around. I'm going to open my Twitter. I'm going to text someone. I could go through my feed and still do what I want to do. That's pretty cool, if you ask me. That's pretty cool. And it's something that's actually been there on some Android phones. Again, it feels like they just ripped off the Android OS. But yeah, it's kind of a cool thing. And it's not only for videos. This can also work here. Normally, when you're in a video call with someone on the iOS 13 and you leave the call, it kind of goes away. It pauses the video. Like, it just goes away and it tells the other person that it's paused for you. This is how it looks like. So it shows that you're paused. But on the iOS 14, it's really different. It's like a different kettle of fish here. Like, it's another thing entirely. You could actually still use your phone. You could leave the app like this. And when you do leave the app, it doesn't go away. It doesn't pause the video. It actually stays on your screen, which is cool. So you could actually answer urgent messages. You could go to your settings or set your alarm, and it will still be on. That's pretty cool. They also added a feature that lets you know if your camera has been used or your audio is in use. I think that one is actually just for paranoid people, to be frank. But who knows, they may still be watching us. So yeah, if you look at the top of the screen, there's a yellow dot to the top right. It shows that my audio has been used, like the show system. So it lets you know if your audio is used. And when your camera is used like this, it does show you that your camera was used recently. Normally shows a green to the top left, like you see. And then when I swipe up, it shows me camera was recently used. It's kind of just there to help me, like, you know, feel safer, I guess. To me, it's no different, to be honest.
This particular one is good news for people who actually like to hide stuff on their phone. Previously, you would have to actually keep sensitive stuff in My Eyes Only on Snapchat because the hidden folder wasn't really hidden. But now you can turn it off, which is cool. And when you turn it off and you go to your photos, you wouldn't actually see the album there. So if you give someone your phone to, you know, go through your pictures, the hidden album isn't there. So you can turn it off or turn it on. You go back to the settings and turn it back on if you don't really have anything you're hiding. So it's actually cool. It's cool.
So yeah, this one is like something that bothered me for a long time. Like, why would I have a phone and I don't want to take a call? For example, I'm in a class and I'm using my phone to check something, maybe an app or something. Someone is calling me, I have to actually sit there and stare at my phone to wait for the call to go away. It was really, really, really annoying, to be frank. It was annoying, but now they fixed that, so it's better. Like, thank you, Apple. What's up? So yeah, when a call is coming in like this, you can easily swipe the call sharply in no time, or you can still keep using it like this if you, as long as you set it to banner mode. Then if you want to get the call back, you go back to your notification center and still take the call.
So there's a setting for that. When you have calls in, you can actually set whether the calls come in a banner or a full screen, so whatever you set. But even then, even if you tap the call and it shows full screen, if you press your home button, you could still get away from it without answering it. So that's kind of cool. You know, part of the whole package of getting a new upgrade is new changes to the looks. So I guess they just did this so it don't feel like the old one, because there's really not much different. Although they give you categories of music in different places, they, you know, try to tweak the whole thing a little, put things in different places. Well, it's pretty much the same app, but kind of, I don't know, I prefer the old one. All this red everywhere is weird. Although there's kind of just one slight tweak, a new control, like an infinity loop to let you play, but otherwise it's pretty much the same and it's cool. I think this one is really cool. I think they tried to make it better, because now you can keep with me your mentions, like when you're in a group and you want to actually mention a particular person, like add them, it works. Then also you can reply messages. That's actually kind of better, like instead of just liking them, or you can actually choose to reply the particular one you want to, and then it would show under that the message got this reply, one reply. It's kind of pretty cool to me. And it's cool. That's pretty much the whole vibe for this new update. I really enjoy how they give you a little more control. There's a lot of easier stuff but tinier, and I don't want to make the video too long. So yeah, I recommend it. Update your phone to iOS 14. So it's going to take a little while, but it's been nice. So thank you for watching this video. Please do not forget to like, share, subscribe.